Bonjour tout le monde. Earlier today, we received the job report for April. These numbers tell us what we already knew, that right now, Canadians are hurting because of this pandemic. Everyone has their own story, but it all boils down to a very difficult time for a lot of people. Canadians aren't alone in this, as the world faces COVID-19. But if you're out of work, you don't need to hear that other people are out of work, too. You need to know that there's a plan to get you through this and get you back on the job. And that's exactly what this government is focused on. Aujourd'hui, on a reçu le rapport sur l'emploi pour le mois d'avril, et les chiffres confirment ce qu'on sait depuis un bon moment. Vous êtes nombreux à souffrir à cause de cette pandémie. Et ce qui compte le plus pour vous, c'est de savoir qui a un plan pour vous aider à passer à travers et retourner au travail le plus rapidement possible. Et c'est là-dessus que notre gouvernement se concentre. In the face of this unprecedented challenge, we've taken action. Maybe you're one of the more than 7 million people getting the CERB to help make ends meet. Or better yet, maybe thanks to the wage subsidy, your employer has been able to rehire you. That's what happened for people who work at Pursuit, a Banff tourism company. They're back on the job because of this program. We created the Canada Emergency Wage Subsidy to protect jobs wherever possible. Since it launched last week, employers have applied for subsidies for almost 2 million workers. And as provinces and territories start to gradually reopen over the coming months, and the CERB becomes less and less needed, this subsidy will play an even greater role. That's why I can announce today that we will be extending the Canada Emergency Wage Subsidy beyond June to help kickstart our economic reopening and boost jobs. We'll have more details next week, but to businesses hit by COVID-19, know this. The wage subsidy will continue to be there for you to help you keep your employees on the payroll. So fill out the application at canada.ca if you haven't already done so. And if you had to let people go, try to bring them back. It's those workers who will drive our economy's short and long-term recovery. On other support, the Canada Emergency Business Account has been accessed by well over 500,000 businesses to give them much-needed loans. Between the CEBA and the wage subsidy, we're helping employers across the country keep Canadians on the job. Now, even though we're reaching millions of Canadians, we need to reach even more. We're working around the clock to update and adjust so that help gets to as many workers, small businesses, families, and young people as possible. We also know that some sectors have been hit especially hard, so we're stepping up on that, too. Minister Baines will be leading a new Industry Strategy Council. Chaired by Monique Leroux, this council will take a deeper dive into how the pandemic is affecting specific sectors and how to best support them. We're leveraging expertise from the economic strategy tables we set up in the first mandate, as well as looking to new industry leaders. This will be a dedicated forum for industry and government to come together on tackling the effects of COVID-19. And it builds on what we've already done for workers in everything from energy to agriculture. On that note, Minister Guilbeault will have more details at noon about how our $500 million package for arts, culture, and amateur sport is now being rolled out to support workers in those sectors. This investment will help people access wage support and help organizations access funding. Our artists, creators, and young athletes inspire us and help us feel connected, even when we're at home. They're there for us, and we're going to be there for them. No matter where you work, no matter who you are, these are tough times. But with the right plan, we will get through this, and we'll come back stronger than ever. Le Canada fait face à un défi sans précédent. Donc, on a pris des mesures sans précédent. Vous êtes peut-être parmi les plus de 7 millions de personnes qui reçoivent la prestation canadienne d'urgence. Ou peut-être que vous avez été réembauché grâce à la subvention salariale d'urgence. Nous avons créé cette subvention pour protéger les emplois autant que possible. Depuis le lancement du programme la semaine dernière, les employeurs ont déjà déposé des demandes de subvention pour presque 2 millions de travailleurs. Et aujourd'hui, j'annonce qu'on va prolonger la subvention salariale d'urgence après le mois de juin pour encourager la relance de l'économie et stimuler la création d'emplois. On aura plus de détails à ce sujet la semaine prochaine, mais les entreprises touchées par la COVID-19 doivent savoir ceci. La subvention salariale va être là pour vous et vos travailleurs. Je vous invite à faire une demande sur le site de canada.ca si ce n'est pas déjà fait. Et si vous avez dû faire des mises à pied, essayez de réembaucher vos employés si possible. Ce sont ces travailleurs qui vont nous aider à relancer l'économie à court et à long terme. Les Canadiens veulent travailler, donc on va les aider à retourner au travail. Grâce à cette subvention et à d'autres mesures comme le compte d'urgence pour les entreprises, on aide les employeurs à garder leurs employés. Aujourd'hui, on a aussi des nouvelles pour le secteur de la culture. Le ministre Guilbeault va donner plus de détails là-dessus, mais en gros, on est en train de soutenir les artistes, les entreprises culturelles, les musiciens, les jeunes athlètes et leurs entraîneurs. Pour mieux comprendre les conséquences de la pandémie sur les différents secteurs de l'économie, on met sur pied le Conseil sur la stratégie industrielle, qui sera dirigé par le ministre Baines. Présidé par Monique Leroux, le Conseil aura pour mission d'étudier plus en profondeur les effets de la pandémie dans des secteurs spécifiques et surtout ce qu'on peut faire pour soutenir les travailleurs. On profite du savoir-faire des tables de stratégie économique qu'on avait mises sur pied durant notre premier mandat et on fait appel à des nouveaux leaders d'industrie. On traverse une période difficile en ce moment, mais avec le bon plan, on va revenir plus fort que jamais. It's hard to think of tougher times for our country, but as our elders remind us, Canada has faced challenges before, and we've always overcome them. Today, we mark the 75th anniversary of Victory in Europe Day and the end of the Second World War on the continent. After 6 years of war, it must have felt like that day would never come, but it did. And it came because of the courage of all who served and because of the sacrifice of all who gave their lives. It has been 75 years since our grandparents and great-grandparents stood up to do their part. 75 years since they stood united and strong to ensure that we would live in peace and freedom. Today, as our generation faces our own battle, let us be inspired by them and their valor as we protect them and all Canadians. This is our challenge, and I know we will rise to meet it. Merci.